Good morning, this is Mayayo speaking for just one more trail running review to be published at trailrunningspain.com in English and carrerasdemontana.com in Spanish. Today, introducing the new Brooks Mazama 2016 interesting novelty to hit the stores by autumn, most probably, and to be a great addition to the Brooks trail running range, which will be, let's say, moving faster, because the Pure Grit is a, let's say, a natural running shoe, and the Cascadia is a, let's say, workhorse, a long running, easy going, you know, shoe, and therefore this Mazama is a lighter, faster, meaner. To be honest, its main numbers to start with, it will retail for around $140. Its weight is 9.3 ounces, that is 260 grams. Its drop, it's 6 millimeters. But as you quickly point out, it's close to the ground. There's not much cushioning below it. Of course, there is a certain amount of cushioning, but limited. So basically, it aims at delivering, let's say, a better feel of the terrain as we step on it. And actually, funny enough, if you add together the lugs plus the midsole plus the insole, which is quite thick, we'll take a look at it later. Actually, you do have about 17 millimeters, which it which is more than, let's say, the European brands for their fast-going shoes like Salomon, but less than most of the USA brands for their, you know, usual trail running shoes. So it's 17 millimeters up here and 23 millimeters back here. Now, if we have to describe, you know, the role, basically, let's start from the bottom up. You know, the outsole pattern, as I pointed out before, is made out of Brooks rubber. That is to say that it's not the most reliable so far. To be honest, Vibram has got the very best outsole rubber, generally speaking. However, some proprietary brand outsoles are also competitive. Basically, the Italian La Sportiva, British Innovate, and French Salomon are three brands which deliver in terms of the compound. However, American brands such as Brooks and New Balance still have to go that extra mile to become as trustworthy when met with slippery rocks and wet. However, for mild circumstances or you know, all terrain, this seems to be a reasonable pattern, with just two further things to be pointed out. One, you see the rock plate built-in protection on 3/4 of the, you know, forefoot. Two, funny, there's a, as you see, a dual structure, whereas the play between the forefoot and the heel is quite wide, probably with a purpose behind it, that as to step on uneven ground, you know, it will give us a greater, you know, stability as we balance ourselves with that way. Now, as we go up, we feel, you know, the chassis here, that is to give us stability with different midsole patterns, as you see, in gray and in yellow. Basically, they blend in this dual density to provide stability and guide the shoe on uneven terrain. Farther on top, now we reach the upper mesh, which does not have a special reinforcement on the side, so just watch out in case during the in-depth reviews that we carry out for 300 miles or so, and we publish later on, we'll see if this can stand the test of the rocks, you know, stepping on rocks or being punctured. However, as for, you know, holding the shoe in place, as you see at Brooks, they have taken extra care to build in, you know, plenty of lines up here, you know, going up, you know, and, you know, just tightening up your feet in place with quite a consistent grip at all times, which, of course, is to help when moving, you know, on a tricky terrain. So, overall, market alternatives to this product. Well, basically in the States, you may come across the New Balance Bassi Summit, which does have a very similar price tag at $120, very similar weight as well, with 270 grams, and a similar multi-lug and rock plate outsole. However, its drop is that of 10 millimeters, which is quite a different geometric approach, and basically it will deliver less feel to the terrain. And if you want to go fast in technical terrain, the better, the closer you are to the ground, the better. On the other hand, of course, internationally speaking, their main rival would be the Salomon S-Lab Sense, with the version, the Sword Lag, the Sense 5 Ultra, this is, okay, which is far more expensive for $180 or so, but in the other respect is quite similar, 240 grams versus 260, and basically we've got a drop of 4 millimeters here versus a drop of 6 millimeters. Main advantage going for the French shoe is that the Salomon rubber has been proved and found very reliable these days. It did not used to be so in the old times, but now since 2015 onwards, Salomon has truly, you know, improved its contra-grip track. So, pending our in-depth test that we will publish later on at Trail Run in Spain or in English and carrerasdemontana.com in Spanish, let me remind you of the numbers, main numbers, for this new Brooks Mazama 2016, which is retails for $140, weight in 9.3 ounces, that is 260 grams, with an intermediate drop of 6 millimeters, which is basically quite convenient for their role as a fast, mean going shoe on the trails. Thank you for your attention and see you soon at Trail Run in Spain and carrerasdemontana.com.